In the hours after the Newtown, Connecticut shooting, two women here in Washington, D.C. said to themselves, we have to do something to keep this from happening again. They came up with the idea of a march on Washington for gun control. And now, just a few weeks later, you can see how their idea has turned to action. All of these people gathered at the steps of the U.S. Capitol on Saturday morning. They walked about a mile to be at the base of the Washington Monument. Their message is that they want Congress to act for gun control. Yet even as they gathered just across the street were members of people who were talking about gun rights. And when you listen to the two sides, you realize how divided they really are.
My two older children, of course, are very aware of what's going on. And I said, you know, I'm going down there to, you know, for you, for us, and to make a difference without sounding corny. But, I mean, it's just piggybacking on the sentiment of the politicians that are in favor of all this change, that as people, as a country, like, we can't keep waiting for all the politicians to make the move. We need to be heard. I mean, we do.
Did Newtown change the way you think at all?
Yes. I could not figure out why government employees have armed guards, banks have armed guard to protect the money, but the government, for some reason, thought we don't need armed guards to protect our children. Maybe they're less worthy. I don't know. I don't know what their thinking was. All I can't understand is why didn't they protect their children like the government protects itself?
The message of this March on Washington was spread largely via Facebook and email listserv messages. People came from all over because they wanted to be a part of it. Yet they say they also realize that any legislation faces an uphill battle in Congress.